Today I'm back in the Ineos Grenadier and we're giving another player a lift home. Here he is.
How are you, Eve? Good to see you, my man. Let's get you out of this horrible weather.
Let's go.
I wish it was mine, man. So tell me how it feels to be properly back in. You had a bit of time at AFCON.
Yeah.
When you came back, Mad has put a story on his Instagram of you dancing. And I was like, this guy has the most unbelievable energy. I think Mad has even said, like, you've been back 5 minutes, you're already dancing, killing it in the changing room. Yeah. Is that something that you try and bring?
No, that's me in general, you know. that's me, you know. I got a lot of energy. And then, to be honest, I miss this changing room as well, you know.
Yeah.
I miss my teammate, I miss everyone. The changing room was a bit quiet, you know.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I said, no, how we can be quiet? You know, it's no chance. This is here, so we're never ever going to be quiet. And then Mother started to film me. And
it went everywhere.
Honest,
you know what
yeah.
kills me in that video is Pape.
Yeah.
He's just standing on the side.
He was doing Gigi. Pape's funny.
I know it sounds obvious because every football player loves football, but you seem to be one of those people that you're happiest when you've got the ball at your feet.
Yeah. Because he's. From the start, you know, it's my passion, you know, to play football, especially on this level, in this league, is amazing for me. And, you know, try to enjoy myself like when I was young.
Take me back to your home when you were a kid.
When I was a kid, I born in Ivory Coast.
Is it the dream of kids there to make it to Premier League one day?
No.
what's the dream?
When you're young, you just, you know, you don't really realize, you know, you're playing just to enjoy. But when I move to the academy, now I start to think, oh yeah, I can have chances to be a professional footballer, you know.
I don't want to get you in trouble with your parents, but another thing that I saw is that you used to hide on Sundays when it was church time, so you could sneak up and play football. And I was like, that is a kid who is obsessed.
Especially my mom. Oh,
did she tell you off?
Yeah, every time I remember.
That's a really lovely memory to have because it reminds you how much you loved football.
Yeah.
That you would have done anything to play.
Yeah, football is my life, you know? Like, I don't know what to do if it's not football, you know? For me, it's not a job. For me, it's passion, you know? It's like a game. I enjoy playing, you know, make people happy, you know, make fans happy, you know? Do, you know, when you have big chances to do what you was dreaming to do, you know. Some people they was dreaming to play football as well, man. They didn't have chances to be professional footballer. You know what I mean? So yeah, for me it's grateful.
When you were in the academy, I saw you say before that you used to play at the bottom levels. You play without boots.
We didn't start with the boots.
Seriously?
Yeah, it was crazy. You have to pass the step.
To get your boots. So how long are you playing barefoot for?
3-4 years. In Africa, I think people start with no shoes. When you get your shoes, it's like you get trophy. You're so happy because now you're starting to play real football now.
Yeah.
You know?
So what's it like then when you move to Lille and you finally, you're in that environment that you want to be? Did you enjoy that or is that then a huge challenge as well?
No, I really enjoy it because I said like, oh, okay, Beast, you was dreaming to be here, so you're here now, let's go, next step. Of course, you're going to enjoy it because you say, oh yeah, thanks God, I'm here, call mom, call dad, oh, I'm in France, I'm playing, we train today, it was like this.
How were your
like
parents
this.
About it? It's a long way to go, huh?
Yeah, very long way. They were so excited.
Really?
They were so happy for me because, you know, my mom and dad, they did everything for me to be what I really wanted to be, you know. They was always with me. My dad stopped his job to just follow me about, everything they was doing, it was just for me to make my dream true, you know. So they're helping me a lot. So to be here now, I just have to say very, very, very thanks to them and God as well.
When you get to Brighton, you have one of the nicest men in football to give you your debut, Chris Hughton.
Chris Hughton, yes. He was like a dad for me. I was happy because I was in Premier League. But at the same time, it was really hard because I was alone and I don't speak the language. You know, I go at training, I don't really understand what they said, you know. So Chris was there to help me every day. every day to try to make me understand what he really wants me to do on the pitch. He was very honest with me, you know. But he told me, "Bis, if you want to play, you're good." Eh? He told me, like, he spoke to me like that. "You're very good. You're very good football player. I think we don't have midfield like you. But if you want to play, especially on this league, change your way to play, run, bro." He told me that. He told me that run. You have to run. You have to understand what the game really wants. Your body language, your position on the pitch, you know, a lot. Even outside the pitch, as well, he gave me a lot of advice. You know, he was texting me every day because, you
really?
Know, yeah, he helped me a lot to be where I am today.
When you get the chance to come to Spurs, are you like, "This is huge"?
Yeah, of course, of course. When I heard Tottenham won me, I was like, "Oh, let's go."
Let's go.
"Come on, you Spurs."
Immediately.
"Let's go, amazing." And yeah, and the, you know, the stadium, fans, the club, oh, everyone's fantastic. You know, so we have everything to work, you know, like really hard to make this team what it needs to be. Because for me, Spurs is one of the best team in the world, you know?
I'm a little bit biased here because my favorite players are always central midfielders. But I think you have the hardest role because every single time you receive the ball, it's under pressure. Is that something that you prep for?
Yeah, the way we want to play, I'm gonna be always in the pressure, you know? But the thing is, you just have to be calm and be smart and know really exactly what you're gonna do when you have the ball. And even when I don't have the ball, just my movement can make a space for my teammates.
Because you have to be brave as well, right? You know, when you receive that pass, it's like, if I make one bad touch here, they're gonna be in. Does that come from Ange saying, "Listen, this is what I want you to do"?
Yeah, he put me there and he told me, like, he trusts the way I play as well, you know? But when he put me there, it's because I can do it. You know, I can do it. Sometimes I don't touch the ball because they come with, they stay on me, you know, like man v man, you know, they don't let me have the ball because they know maybe if I have the ball, I can do something special and we can score a goal. You know, my first thing is not about scoring goal. Just try to help the team to play very well. And when we don't have a ball, try to have a ball quicker.
I want to talk about your passions outside of football.
Yeah.
You are one of the best dressed footballers I've ever seen. Sometimes when I see, you know, now we're doing the arrival videos to training. Yeah. It's almost like a competition. I'm not joking. I see you guys come in, and particularly you come in and you look incredible. And then you see everyone else. It's like a bar now. It's like setting levels.
No, it's not like a competition bar, you know.
Right, don't lie. I know. So I've got a bit of a challenge for you then. I want to know which players in the team are the best dressed. So I'm going to get you to have a look at these. It's in the glove box, actually. And on the cards is pictures of players in the team. And we're going to rank them in order of who's the best.
All right.
There you go. Who's on top? There you go. Who's on top?
Of course it's me. This is normal for me.
This is the normal day at the office for you. Good. Who's next? Bit of Pedro, is it?
Pedro, dressing like he's going to be married.
Yeah.
Yeah, my man.
Is this Destiny?
Yeah, Des.
He looks Des. Great, huh?
He look very good. But he copy me, you know.
Who else have we got?
Mickey. Yeah, Mickey's, you know, he's class.
Yeah,
you know?
Classy guy.
Class,
yeah.
Very normal, natural. Brennan? Yeah, he's a bit different like me.
He's quite unique though, right? His style is quite unique, Brennan.
Yeah, he's a bit different. The way he dresses, I really like. It's not my type, but I like the way he dresses.
Yeah.
Papio! But you see, Pape, the way he dresses, you know, he's a bit like this. So, yeah.
Okay. He's learning off the bat.
Vicario! Italian style, yeah. No, Vicario dressed very good as well. Big Mades!
He dresses well as well.
Yeah, I love his dressing. I think he's one of the best as well.
Your fashion sort of bleeds into your kit because your boots are unbelievable. Tell me the story about why you have chosen to have the boots that you do.
everywhere I am, you know, when people show me love, I show them the same love. So that's why I just making my boots on my country flag and my club flag as well. It's a message as well, you know, it's a message to show like, oh, I'm here, I'm happy to be here. I work really hard with my flag, you know, with my Tottenham badge on my shirt, on my things, on my boots, you know, I really like, you know.
So I've got a little bit of a surprise for you actually.
Oh yeah?
Because I thought you like your boots.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna just go and quickly get something out of the back.
Can I close my eyes or?
What I've got here.
Yeah.
Is some of the best limited edition versions of your boots.
Yeah.
And we're gonna rank them now from best to worst.
All right.
Let's start with these. So light.
Yeah.
Okay, they're number one. Do you remember that advert where they were doing the cage, the 3v3 in the cage? So it's like Roberto Carlos, Ronaldo Phenomeno, era, okay? Oh. Do you remember these?
Yeah, of course.
So sick.
These. Yeah.
Then we have these. These are like absolute beasts as well.
Yeah, this is amazing. I remember this as well. I think Drogba was playing with this, no?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Then we get into the special ones.
Yeah.
Do you remember this? 1998, these are match worn.
No way.
Yeah.
Ronaldo.
Yeah.
R9.
Do you know, Richie's going to be so jealous. We've got a pair of match worns, but Ronaldo Phenomeno signed them as well.
Wow.
So.
Wow.
So how did you design this boot?
Like in England, it's three lions, yeah?
Three lions, yeah.
But in Mali, it's Egel, you know, Egel. So this is the Egel here. This is my son name here.
Oh, amazing.
Mile, yeah, that's my son name. And that's my initial YB8.
Give me your best to worst.
So yeah, this one.
Number one, right, cool, I'll take that.
Yeah, I think this one is second. I put this one and maybe this one on four.
Number four?
Number four.
Are you kidding? Yeah. I would have had that at the top.
Yeah. I like it, but compared to all of these, because Ronaldo put this one, you know, so for me, I can't put my shoe in.
You can't put it ahead of Ronaldo.
Me, no.
Tell you what, I'll give you these back, because you need them for when you next year. I'll steal them and leave in the car. Right, I'll pop these back in the boot and then we'll take you home. You said to me before, a little while ago, I love that feeling, looking at the fans, because it allows you to dream. You just get carried away and you dream.
Yeah.
What do you dream about? What are the things that you think, in your future, this is what I want to do?
The most thing was really important for me now, I think, is try to put the club where it deserves, you know, because the fan, they deserve it. You know, the club deserve it. Tottenham is big. Big club, and is for me is one of the best club in the world, and the best club in the whole world need to have what they need to have. Do you know what I mean? That's why we're here. We're working really hard. It's not easier, yeah, but we will do everything to put the club where it need to be. That's my dream. But yeah, it's a big challenge, so we're ready for that, and yeah.
This has been such a fun trip home. Thank you so much for joining us.
Right,
anytime you need a lift, you go to jail.
Who have we got next then? Back to the training ground.